Scientists have discovered a new fat loss hack, and it actually seems to work. The research is based on what is called the meal recall effect. Multiple previous studies have found that when you actively visualize a meal that you previously ate before you consume another meal, it reduces your intake. So basically, reliving a memory can enhance the satiety you get from a meal. This new research found that we can enhance the meal recall effect further by imagining that the meal we just ate, the meal we ate before we're going to eat now, was twice the size that it was, that it actually was. Now, you don't have to actually believe that the meal was bigger. The researchers also found that it did not, this kind of self-trickery did not actually make people think the meal was twice as large. What seems to have happened is that when you recall a previous meal and you're kind of pretending that it was bigger, then it relives the memory in your experience, and it creates what neuroscientists sometimes call a sensory shadow, which basically means that you're reactivating the satiety signals that were activated when you consumed the meal. Also, it enhances interoception. Interoception is our ability to look inside of us and feel our body signals, essentially. So when you're eating, and there's also in general a lot of research that mindful eating improves satiety and reduces how much you eat, because it's a similar mechanism, it's also interoceptive. It means that you're actively aware of all the satiety signals that your body's producing. You feel that you're actually consuming food, you are chewing on the food enough, you're noticing that food is actually passing through, you're noticing that your stomach is more full, and you're noticing the changes that happen in your brain when you receive these satiety signals and you no longer feel the same desire to eat. Whereas if you eat mindlessly, research finds that when you eat in front of the TV or when you're eating, if you're eating right now, then research finds that you can overeat because you're literally, your brain is not processing the satiety signals, it's processing other information. And as a result of that, you overeat. So it sounds kind of ridiculous, but your brain literally needs to pay attention to you eating and to your food to make sure that it's processing the satiety signals. If your brain is occupied, it literally isn't giving you the same satiety signals. And the meal recall effect in this study with the self-trickery was 32% reduced calorie intake. So it's actually significant. Now, in this case, they used biscuits. I would definitely like to see this replicated, ideally in strength trainees that eat, you know, a big-ass post-workout meal, and then see, okay, how much are we actually talking about here? But if based on this study, 32% is significant. A smaller research has found 10%+ from a simple meal recall, even without the self-trickery of pretending it was bigger. So that's clearly substantial. If we can reduce our daily energy intake by 10% even, which is one of the lower estimates in these studies, that is very, very substantial. So that would mean this is something that is actually worth trying. Interestingly, in this study, the meal recall did, and pretending the meal was bigger, did not influence the actual portion size estimate. So the participants were also asked to rate how big the previous meal was, which was their first meal before they had the second meal, in which they ate less after the self-trickery. And when they were asked to rate the size of the first meal, the trickery, the self-trickery, the mental recall effect, it did not influence the portion size estimate. In fact, portion size estimate of the first meal was still an underestimation compared to reality. So most research finds that people significantly underestimate the size of a meal if they don't actually weigh and track the calories. And the effects can be very, very large. Even trained dietitians do this. And this study adds to that literature and shows that even when you're kind of pretending to yourself that you think the meal was bigger, you're still likely to underestimate how many calories you had. And I see this all the time in clients. If they're not as super well versed yet in dieting, like I haven't coached them that long yet, I very often see that when they had one meal that was slightly out of bounds, you know, but they're pretty sure they didn't overeat. It's very often actually that you do overeat quite substantially because of hidden calories. Like, you don't know what you don't know. So if there were sugar or oils in the meal, it can very quickly rack up the calories without you being aware of that. And not to mention that we have a tendency in general to kind of glorify and to make our memories more positive, and also, you know, forget the dessert or the second dessert, or, you know, the latte that you had. And if you really want to shock yourself, then try to estimate how many calories a double peanut butter sandwich has. Like when bulking, I like double sourdough sandwiches with peanut butter, like 100% pure peanut or almond. And if you estimate the amount of calories that is in one double sandwich, and then you actually measure it, prepare to be shocked. All right, so what can we do with this research? Personally, I always struggle a great deal with this kind of self-trickery, but my clients have reported great results with them, things like cognitive reappraisal and gratefulness exercises. They work well for a lot of people, and many of my clients report good results with them. So definitely give this a try and let me know how well it works for you. And if you want to see more of these videos, then don't forget to like and subscribe.